will do the titration. Aim of our titration is to prepare MY 100 ml oxalic acid solution and find molarity and strength of supplied KMnO4 solution. We start this titration. First, we'll prepare the solution of oxalic acid. Molarity given to us M/100 and volume is 100. For M/100 solution, I have a 0.126 gram of oxalic acid. How to weigh and how to calculate, that will be explained to you later. So, first we'll prepare the oxalic acid solution. For that, we take a small beaker. In a small beaker, we pour 0.126 gram of oxalic acid and add water. We'll try to mix this oxalic acid in small amount of water. Then we'll make the 100 ml volume in volumetric flask. See here, few particles are left. So again we will swirl it in a proper way. See, almost all particle of oxalic acid soap dissolved in a water. Now we transfer this into volumetric flask, right? In this flask we'll make the 100 ml volume of oxalic acid solution, right? We are transferring into volumetric flask. A few particles are left. Okay. Now we add more water. As you know, in this volumetric flask there is a 100 ml mark. For that we should be very careful by pouring the water. You see, this is a 100 ml mark solution. 100 ml last few drop we will add with the help of pipette. Now you see this 100 ml mark circle is being touched. So first part of titration, prepare M/100 oxalic acid solution in 100 ml is being done. Now this solution we will use for titration purpose. For that, what we will do? Again we'll transfer this solution into a small beaker. Right? On this process we will hold. First, we will pour the KMnO4 solution in unit. First, check it is tightly closed. See it very carefully. this is a water I'm keeping aside. Right? And now I'll check. This is a purple. This is a bit more quality. I am keeping this scale on my side. Later I will show you how to fill buboid and how to measure the scale. Now you see, upper portion is on 0 ml and it is filled completely. Now buboid is ready, our solution is ready. Now we start the titration. For that, what we'll do, we'll transfer the solution into a small beaker. We'll cap it. This is a 100 ml oxalic solution which we have prepared earlier. Now 20 ml solution, we'll pip it out in a conical flask with the help of pipet. You see, this is a 20 ml pipet. Here a circle is there. This is a 20 ml mark. Few drops are needed. See carefully, this is a 20 ml mark and we have filled the 20 ml oxalic acid solution which we have prepared few minutes back, transferring into conical flask. Okay. And now we add 1 test tube sulfuric acid in this conical flask. This is a dilute sulfuric acid. 1 test tube means around 15 ml. Okay. See carefully. Till now what we have done, we have prepared 100 ml oxalic acid solution by weighing 0.126 gram of oxalic acid, added water and make up a volume 100 ml. Then we filled the buboid with KMnO4, then transferred 20 ml of oxalic acid solution in a conical flask with the help of pipet, right? Then added 1 test tube sulfuric acid, right? Up now we maintain the temperature of this oxalic acid solution. For that we have to heat this oxalic acid solution to maintain the temperature, say 60 degrees. Okay, this 60 degree you can measure it by counting 60 or in a 1 minute. Just see me. Why we are heating it up? Because oxalic acid is slowing the reaction by heating it. We are fasting the rate of reaction. Here the flame is right. Okay, see the flame. So I believe 60 degree temperature is maintained. I think 20 more seconds are needed to maintain the right temperature. See here, 60, 70, 80, 90. Say around 1 minute 30 seconds we have heated it up and 60 degree temperature is maintained. How we will check? We are holding it in a light manner. If you hold it or you touch it from the bottom, your hand will go away. So you see, this is 60 degree temperature is maintained. Now we start the titration. Okay. We will use the Parallax cup to take the reading. This is a simple paper card. Okay. See the process? Slowly and slowly, we will be pouring KL-104 in a 60 degree temperature maintained oxalic acid solution. Here KL-104 is reacting with oxalic acid. We will try to find the end point. When we will assume endpoint has come, when light permanent pink color will be there. Reaction is going on. Drop by drop, we are adding the KL-104 in an oxalic acid. See the process. KL-104 is reacting with oxalic acid. I believe permanent light pink color has come. We should wait for 10 seconds. If it will remain, it means our reaction is completed. See, this is a light permanent pink color and endpoint has come. Now we take the reading of burette. Okay. First I will see from my side. Then I will show you what is the exit reading. I believe it is a 7.6 mm. See all of you. you know, first reading for 20 ml oxalic acid to bring the endpoint 7.6 ml KMnO4 is being consumed. This is our first reading. Same process we will repeat by 3 times. Out of 3 times, 2 reading will be the similar reading. Or if you will do the process in a proper way, definitely 2 similar readings will come. That 2 similar readings will be considered as a concordant volume that will be used for the calculation of molarity of this given KNO4 solution. Thank you.